just don't make sense. I can't see it now, but I'm still convinced that there's just some problems only God can fix.
Still a strong tower. I find my safety in him, he is
still a strong tower, still a strong tower.
I'm at home in your presence. could stay here forever. I've searched the world and found nothing is better. No, nothing is.
How easily you fill up the room when you're welcomed in.
I've searched the world
and found. it's only you, Jesus.
Nothing is better.
It is only you, Jesus. Tried a lot of things, but I know it's only you, Jesus. Drank from a lot of wells, and I know that Jacob's well will never do. I need to draw from you. Drawn from a lot of wells, and I know that Jacob's well will never do. Lord, I need to draw from you. Nothing else will do it. Jacob's well will never do. I need to draw from you. To draw from you, oh Jesus. So, oh, I'm at home in your presence. Oh, everything else comes second. Oh, I could stay here forever. I've searched the world and found. Nothing is better.
I used to dam those desert valleys. Now I thank you for those droughts. I used to curse the walls around me, but now I see you had it figured out. And it was all working for my good. If only I knew back then what I know right now. Oh, nothing is wasted in your hands. God, you didn't forsake me, and I know you never will. Oh, there is beauty in the ashes. There's a peace within the storm. Oh, and there's a song for every season. So don't stop singing on and on until you see the sun. 'Cause it was all working for my good. I see it now. If only I knew back then what I know right now. Oh, nothing is wasted in your hands. God, you didn't forsake, and I know you never will. Oh, I know you never will. Trust you, even when I don't see you, I still trust you. When I don't understand, I'll still lift my hands and worship.
when I should have lost my mind. You showed up right on time and carried me through the valley, all the way on the other side.
And when pain tried to take my joy, that's when I felt you more. Now I'm gonna testify, God, you kept my heart alive.
Oh, yes, you did.
I didn't know if I'd survive. I gave up so many times, but you kept.
Come on, raise that, raise it.
And I know you never will.
know some of you are going through some stuff.
God, you didn't forsake.
I know it's been a rough year,
and I know you never will.
But you got to sing this over your life.
God, you didn't forsake.
He's with you now.
And I know you never will.
You're not alone tonight.
God, you didn't forsake me.
You're not.
Starts changing. Oh, I'm gonna worship till I mean every word. 'Cause the way I feel and the fear I'm facing doesn't change who you are or what you deserve.
Come on.
I give you my worship. You still deserve it.
Hello? Okay. Good morning.
Good morning.
Wait, let me get into costume first. Hold on. Give me one. Hello, I'm Chris Archer. (Clears throat) We would like to welcome you both here in person and online to everyone's favorite service of the year, Youth Sunday. I know the circumstances are a bit different today, but thank you to all who are here with us. Quick reminder to please sign in on the attendance sheets, and before we get started, I have some religious trivia for you. Where was King David's temple located? Anybody? Above his ear. Okay, I'm done. Let's get this party started. Please settle in and listen to Caitlin play Amazing Grace.
Thank you. Please join with me in the opening call. Love is God.
All the time.
May the Christ among us. May the Christ in me see the Christ in you.
We have a few quick announcements for you today, so who would like to go first? Craig.
Hey, good morning. All right. Brian told me to hold it like I'm eating a Christ ice cream cone, but I don't do ice cream cones, so I'm trying to eat it like I'm slurping a spaghetti strand. So, first, Caitlin, not only are you this year's chili champion, but an amazing piano player, so that's really cool. Next Sunday, you don't have to worry about dinner, because dinner will be here at 5 p.m. We have our potluck. What better way to break in the basement than a potluck? So bring something, and this is a multicultural potluck at 5 o'clock tomorrow here in the basement, and not next week, not tomorrow, Sunday next week. And so what we're going to do is just, you know, the thing about food is it tells a story. And so when we get to potluck together, we share, we fellowship, we share our love, and we also share food, and food tells a story. Bring something that is kind of tells a story about the food that's in your family. Maybe it's what, when y'all get together at dinner, what really is the family dinner? Or if you think about a dish that's gone down through your family tree, what is that dish? Or if you want to think about where you're from, the community or the culture or the heritage that you're from, what is that dish? I know for me, home is eventually going to be the Texas Hill Country, Hook'em. And when I think of Texas Hill Country, cheese enchiladas are more common than cheeseburgers. And so cheese enchiladas are coming. For Debbie, who is, she didn't make it today. Oh, there she is, all right. In her family, they serve sour cream pound cake so often that they call it cake. Everything else is just dessert. So, you know, it's those type of things. I was actually thinking about my dad, and whenever dad wanted, when I was a little kid and I had black hair and a lot of it, he would always, you know, if he wanted to have a heart-to-heart with me, there was a Dilly Bar involved. And so he'd always have to go get a Dilly Bar. So it'd be completely appropriate for me to bring a big box of Dilly Bars. I'm not doing that, but that would be completely appropriate. Anyway, bring something food that tells the story of your hair, of your family, or of where y'all are from. And we'll get together at 5 o'clock and break in the basement with a good St. Luke potluck.
What did you say? I was supposed to hold it like an ice cream cone? I don't know. Anyway, peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. So a couple weeks ago, between services, a whole bunch of you helped us, and we did peanut butter and jelly sandwiches between the 9 and the 10:30 service, and we made over 20 dozen peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, and we delivered them to Youth Emergency Services, and they were very gracious for our donation. So we're, thank you. That was great. Nice. Thank you all for helping. So we're talking about doing that every third Sunday. I don't know that we'll necessarily always do peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, and I'm not sure that we'll always go to Youth Emergency Service, but it'll be up to whatever everybody wants to do. So 2 weeks from today, which would be the third Sunday, which I also understand is St. Patrick's Day, which has nothing to do with peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, but come anyway, we're going to make peanut butter and jelly sandwiches again, and then we'll talk to the group about what we want to do, but target the third Sunday of every month between services. We'll do, I don't know, something. So thank you very much. Roger.
Good morning.
Good morning.
All right, this crowd gets it. Okay. Saturday the 16th, we're going to have our caregiver support group again at 1:30 in the afternoon. So if you're a caregiver or know a caregiver, we'd love to have you come and join us. This is a safe place where all the caregivers can share what's going on. You know, you can say anything, whatever's on your mind, whatever. And we're getting together, the group together, and to maybe do some more programming and things that as we come across there. So we've got a couple of topics coming up over the next couple of months. Things that are near and dear to everybody's heart or concerns. So you're welcome to come. If you know a caregiver that is, you know, it could probably benefit for some conversation with peers, people that are doing the same thing, please invite them. Have them contact me, and you're welcome to come. If the person you're caring for needs to come with you, that would be great. Becky Riley is volunteered to be with us. She'll speak once in a while with us, and then she'll sit with and with the people you're caring for while the rest of us go up and have a good, safe conversation about a number of things. So again, the 16th at 1:30.
Hi, I'm Caitlin. Next week in youth group, we're starting to fill the 5,000 Easter eggs needed for the Easter egg hunt, but we also still need a lot of candy, so would you please consider donating individually wrapped candies to meet our goal, 2,000 more pieces, And you can leave your donations on the table outside of the conference room, or you can give them directly to Sarah Archer. Thank you for your help.
Hi, my name is James. Every Wednesday night when we come to youth group, we arrive hungry. Having a hot meal before youth group starts makes for a much more pleasant evening. Would you consider donating a meal or funds toward a meal? We have several spots still open. To sign up, you could go to the QR code on the back of the bulletin, or you could talk to Sarah Archer. By the way, my favorite meal is Raising Cane's chicken fingers. Chisine.
Hi, I'm Sahajra. Next Sunday happens to be Daylight Saving this year. And in St. Luke Kids, it is our annual Pancakes and Pajamas Day. Parents, why struggle like to get kids dressed or fed when everyone has lost an hour of sleep? Just load them up and head to church. We will celebrate our cute PJs and eat some yummy pancakes as part of Sunday school that morning. St. Luke Kids has got your time change covered.
Thanks for coming this morning. This is Church in the Basement 1.0. Next week, it'll be 1.1. So if you notice things that you think would make it better if we could just change it, I'm breaking one of the Marshall Pastor rules. Usually I tell you, don't tell me anything on Sunday mornings because I'm not going to remember it. This morning, we're making an exception. You could tell me, or Roger will be in his office after the service, and sit down and tell him. We need to know what you're seeing so that we can figure out how to make things better. I don't know if we can do them all, but we will certainly try to do some. Tomorrow morning, if you're free at 9 o'clock, we've got the punch list of different things that just need to get done to finish up the move. So if you've got time to come help with that, that would also be great. Thanks.
Okay. Thank you, everyone. I would now like you all to join me in the opening prayer. O God, whom I call love, you welcome me into this time of worship and remind me that this world, this place, and this moment belong to you. You welcome me to join you as a traveler on a journey I do not always want or understand. You ask that I welcome the stranger, feed the hungry, clothe the naked, and comfort those who mourn. O God, whose name is love, I ask that as I learn and grow and attempt to serve you in others, that I will be given the grace to love you and my neighbor in all that I do. Help me understand that together as a community of faith, we can offer to you our prayers, our presence, our gifts, and our service in the hope of becoming a more loving community created in your image. We pray that at the end of each day, we can say that those to whom love is a stranger will have found in each of us and in our community generous friends. Amen. Okay, now join the choir in hymn number 2243, We Are All One in Mission.
Okay, so we're having some problems with having multiple mics in this space. So for joys and concerns, just stand up and say your joy or your concern, and I'll repeat it into the microphone for those at home to hear. So does anybody have any joys or concerns? So for those of you at home, her and Sasha auditioned for their school play, and they both got parts in it. Anyone else? So for those of you at home, her brother has stage 4 cancer and had to go to the ER. But was it because they filed for bankruptcy?
No.
Part of it. Okay, so they filed for bankruptcy, and they were also able to keep their home. So some good and the bad. All right, is there anyone else? God of love, we come to you in prayer, lifting to you the joys and concerns, the hopes and dreams of all lives here today. Help us remember and recognize how we are all connected and live interdependent on you and each other. We open to your voice in our lives, that we may see with new eyes and hear with new ears the direction you will have us go. Bless this gathering of your people, that we may grow and flourish in your love and grace for the purpose to which you have called us. Please hear our prayers for those whose lives have touched us, those who are in pain, those who are ill, and those who grieve. May we touch their lives not only through our prayers, but through our actions as well. Guide us, bless us, lift us, and hold us as we are your children. We pray in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Now is the time that we can stand up and greet each other. Keep going. If everyone can start finding their seats, we'll keep going. If everyone can start finding their seats, we'll keep going on with the sermon.
Today's scripture lesson is 1 Corinthians 12, verses 12 through 26. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many are one body, so it is with Christ. For by one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and all were made to drink of one Spirit. For the body does not consist of one member, but of many. If the foot should say, because I am not a hand, I do not belong to the body, that would not make it any less a part of the body. And if the ear should say, because I am not an eye, I do not belong to the body, that would not make it any less a part of the body. If the whole body were an eye, where would be the hearing? If the whole body were an ear, where would be the sense of smell? But as it is, God arranged the organs in the body, each one of them, as he chose. If all were a single organ, where would the body be? As it is, there are many parts, yet one body. The eye cannot say to the hand, I have no need of you. Nor again the head to the feet, I have no need of you. On the contrary, the parts of the body which seem to be weaker are indispensable. And those parts of the body which we think less honorable, we invest with greater honor, and our unpresentable parts are treated with greater modesty, which our more presentable parts do not require. But God has so composed the body, giving the greater honor to the inferior part, that there may be no discord in the body, but that the members may have the same care for one another. If one member suffers, all suffer together. If one member is honored, all rejoice together. Hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to the church. Thanks be to God.
Good morning. I apologize, I masked because I have a sick kid at home, and while I have no symptoms, I don't want to share any germs I might have gotten from him. So I just wanted to let you know what a great honor it is to be working with these great group of kids. I've almost been working with them a full year. I took over in July for Chris, and wasn't sure I could do it. In fact, I remember sitting in Marshall's office saying, what am I doing? Anyways, both of he and Chris encouraged me that, you know these kids. What's so scary? And I'm like, yeah, you're right. What's so scary? I like these guys. And they're pretty awesome. I was thinking, I was meeting with them about what our theme was going to be for this Sunday. And we sat and we talked, and I left it to them. I left it to them to come up with the idea. And they decided that the theme for this Sunday should be connectedness, reflecting on how we are all connected together as the youth are part of the church and as you are part of the greater church, and how we need each other in community. And I was blown away by their insightfulness, and that's why we chose the scripture we did today, because it definitely reflects about being part of the whole group. It made me remember the scripture in 2 Timothy that talks about, let no one look down on your youthfulness, but rather in your faith and in your heart and your speech and your conduct, show yourself an example. And that's what these kids are. They definitely exemplify Christ and God's love to others. You're going to get to see that in just a minute when they come up and introduce themselves and answer some questions. But before we do, I want to thank our youth leaders. We couldn't do it without them. They are here week in, week out. They show up and they don't get paid. And this is Becky. She leads our senior high Sunday school, and she rocks a hairnet and exemplifies grace. This is Daniel. And Daniel was our fearless van driver for our mission trip last summer, and every week he is a brave middle school minder. He helps us manage those middle schoolers, and the photos are courtesy of his son, so thanks, Gavin. This is Michelle. Michelle is a quiet calm and a steady presence, and let me tell you, that is much needed in the great shenanigans that happen, especially in middle school. This is Wally. Wally, also known as Jeff Walgren. The kids call him Wally, and back in the fall, we said we should name ourselves. We should name our senior high youth group, and so they went off, and the middle school was picking their name, and the senior high were picking their name, and they settled on Wally's Wonderful World of Christian Warriors Omaha chapter. And yes, I got that middle photo from Rachel, texted her in college. There's Chris. Well, he is no longer the youth director. He is here still every Wednesday night helping me, and I personally think he's very helpful and handsome. I promised him I wouldn't tell everybody that he is my personal eye candy, but oops, I forgot. Anyway, we could not do what we do with the youth without these amazing leaders who are here today. You should stand up so we can give you a little clap. Thank you, thank you, thank you for all that you do. So, before we go any further, because I could keep talking for quite a while, I think you should hear from our middle schoolers. The first one we're going to show you is Lawson. He was here Wednesday and recorded a video because he knew he would not be here this morning.
I wish we did more of the good things like escape rooms and like fun nights like that.
It's all good. It's all good. In case anybody didn't catch it, that song says, "Welcome to our house." Since we're in the youth space, welcome to our house. Middle schoolers, come on up. We have only a fraction of the middle schoolers we had at the early service. Some of them had to get to other things like dance performances today. So introduce yourself. They're going to say what grade they're in and their favorite ice cream flavor. This is a trend we do in youth group.
Hello. My name is James. I'm in sixth grade. And my favorite ice cream flavor is mint chocolate chip. And
they also had a question to answer.
Yeah. And my favorite thing to do at youth group is insult Chris.
My name is Levi. I'm in seventh grade. And my favorite ice cream flavor is Rocky Road. My favorite game in youth group is sardines, which is where one person hides and everyone else looks for them. If you're the last person to find them, then you're the one who hides next.
Uh-huh. Martin has a good
one. So, my name is Martin, and I'm in sixth grade, and my favorite ice cream flavor is Snickers ice cream. And, my favorite lifetime memory is, so it was from a while ago, I was 3 years old, but I might get it wrong, but, so it was when my little brother, he was like a newborn baby, but it was when he first looked at me, and, yeah, so, it was like our family photographer was taking pictures, and she was changing the lens, so I walked up, and then all of a sudden, he just opens his eyes, and then I just get tiny baby staring at me, so it was really nice, fun.
A good memory.
I know. All right, senior high. That's a good memory, Marin. All right, now, Mr. Walgren, will you join us? Wally. Wally's going to ask the senior high some questions, and then after they introduce themselves, of course, and say their favorite ice cream flavor. And then we'll open it up for you guys to ask them some questions.
So prepare your questions, but we'll remember name, grade, right? All right. Charlotte.
My name is Charlotte.
I'm a senior, and my favorite ice cream flavor is either chocolate cherry or chocolate strawberry.
My name is Caitlin. I'm a senior, and my favorite ice cream flavor is cookie dough.
My name is Gavin. I'm a senior, and my favorite ice cream flavor is probably a tie between cookies and cream or coffee ice cream.
My name is Emerson. I'm a sophomore, and my favorite ice cream flavor is Rocky Road.
All right, Charlotte. What is your favorite mission trip or youth group memory?
Last year, we went to Minnesota, Minneapolis, and Daniel and Aiden and I got tasked with cleaning up a fire, and I personally think it was really fun to kind of investigate the fire and figure out like where it came from and what, you know, kind of happened there.
All right, Caitlin, what does love, whom we call God, look like to you?
Okay, so I kind of think that, like, love is all around, just like in everything we do and in other people. So to me, that kind of also means that God is also all around and is, like, there whenever you need him.
All right. Gavin, what is something you passionately believe in?
So something I passionately believe in is just be good to other people. Something I think about a lot is I used to kind of work / volunteer at this summer camp, and one of their sayings was always not just treat other people how you want to be treated, but treat other people how they want to be treated. And that's just something that when I heard that, it really impacted me because, I mean, it made a lot of sense to me.
Emerson,
What does justice look like to you?
Justice to me looks like everybody takes accountability for their actions. It doesn't matter what race you are, what you do for work. Like, it doesn't matter. We're all equal, and everybody has to take accountability.
All right. Do we have any questions from the group?
Hello again. How has youth group changed your life?
I honestly have no idea where I'd be without youth group. It's been such a big part of my life since even before seventh grade, when like actual youth group started, like with Mission Kids and stuff. I've known Caitlin and Gavin since I was very young, and so like if I think back and they weren't there, there would be a hole missing. And I feel like youth group makes me whole.
Kind of like building off of that, but I've met so many like amazing people through youth group, and I guess it's kind of just like made me feel like it's like somewhere where I belong, and it's like given me a community to be a part of.
So for me, even before youth group, back when it was just like Sunday school and Club 56 back in fifth grade, it just really kind of closed my relationship with God and also gave me a sense of community and allowed me to personally grow and also be able to make new friends.
So going off of what they all said, I've been coming here for I don't know how long, but recently I've been like in a lot of sports, and I haven't been able to come on Wednesday nights when we all meet up. And I felt like something was like missing when I wasn't going there. My bad. I'm taking a step back from sports now, so I feel like me being able to come on Wednesday nights is gonna help me like grow more towards God now.
Your favorite old people movie.
Listen, I don't want to offend anybody because I don't know when this movie was made, but Goodfellas is a really good movie.
I guess the one that comes off of my, like right off the top of my head would be Taxi Driver. I think a big part is just the fact that they're coming and they're looking to redeem themselves. I think shows a lot of courage and accountability. And so I think you can show them love just in acknowledging that they're trying to change their life and they're trying to be better people.
The science field at UNO.
I'm going to Lincoln, and I'm majoring in journalism.
I am going to UNO, and I'm majoring in psychology.
In
I really enjoy art and drawing. It's kind of an escape for me. Not from anything bad, but just if I've had a rough day, I just sit down and I draw whatever's in my head, and I just put all my emotions out onto the paper, and it helps me to feel better.
I really enjoy reading, I guess, because it kind of, like, helps me get away, like, from my busy life and kind of just, like, go into another world.
I don't really do too much. I just kind of watch movies, play video games. Sometimes I read, and sometimes I just kind of doodle.
Sports is like my biggest hobby. Like after a long day at school, you can just go to practice after school and just take everything off your mind. You don't have to think about anything for like 2 hours.
Other questions?
One of the questions from the earlier service I thought was really good, not for the seniors, Emerson, was how do you pull in the junior high and welcome them into senior high? How do you see that working out?
So I look up to these people a lot. I think their leadership is, like, amazing, and I want to be that. So I was talking about how Gavin, always on Wednesday nights, a lot of his friends come. So me and Sam were talking about how we, like, might ask some of our friends, and if they want to come, they can come. That'd be great. But if they don't want to come, we're not losing anything. So it'd be more fun if they losing my parents.
Probably say right now with graduation coming soon, I'd say one of my bigger fears is kind of just getting stuck in place, not really continuing to grow or move forward in my life.
One of my biggest fears is probably just like growing up and not being able to do everything that I like wanted to do. I guess just, like, I don't know, like, getting to the end of my life and, like, realizing that I, like, wasted some of it, I guess.
Failing, like, anything, really. Failing to complete college, complete high school, failing to start a family, like, anything. Like, I don't want to be, like, living somewhere by myself, completely shut off from everything, and I just don't want to be alone. Are our schools more connected or more divisive between the people? I'm not really sure. At Burke, there's a lot of separate groups, but I feel like if we need to interact, it's normally not a big deal. Like, people don't go out of their way to talk to everybody. Like, not everybody's friends with everybody. But I feel like that's not the case anywhere. Like, I feel like you always have your group and then everybody else.
Is it fair to say that your groups at school maybe aren't just you? Like, you guys have your own groups and kind of cross over?
Yeah. Yeah, because we all go to the same high school, and I see them a fair amount, but we don't really have the same friend groups by any means.
High school, it's not as scary as it seems, and it's definitely very different than like how they show it in movies. I was talking to a teacher one time about kind of the difference between high school and real life high school and movies. And there was something he said that kind of stuck with me. It's that high school in movies exaggerates the wrong things than what it's actually like. And so I would say high school's not as scary. Preparing for graduation, I would say it's a little more scary when you're kind of in that seat. But from what I've kind of heard from people, once you get over that hill, then it's not nearly as scary as it is now.
Yeah, so high school definitely isn't, like, as scary as it seems. But also, I would definitely, like, recommend getting involved in, like, joining something, like a club or a sport, because that definitely, like, improved my high school experience a lot. Because if I, like, just went to school every day and, like, did nothing else, I feel like it would be really boring and it'd be kind of hard to, like, meet other people. So getting involved has definitely helped a lot.
So this may sound like common sense, but I cannot stress enough how important it is to be nice to your teachers. Like, do not be the annoying class clown. Like, nobody thinks they're funny. Like, the first couple jokes, okay, yeah, whatever. But then after a while, it gets really old, and being nice takes you so much farther in high school. And you'll have those connections with your teachers. You'll make better friends. People that you want to surround yourself with will be, you know, attracted to you or whatever. And yeah, you'll have a better high school experience if you're nice.
I wanted to take a second and point out some of our other regular middle schoolers who happen to be not here Wednesday, so that we didn't get a recording of them, and they're also not able to be here Sunday. But we wanted to make sure you knew about them because they are consistently here. And that would be Isaac, Colin, Lane, Meadow, Braden. Anyways, we love them. They're all middle schoolers. So as you can imagine, middle school is a lot of fun. I think we're at the point where we are going to sing again. So shall we stand up and sing? Hymn number 2153. I guess it's in the black book.
I asked Levi if I could make a quick announcement before he gives the benediction. As you leave, if you would pick up the hymnals, the purples and the blacks, and put them on the carpet ball table in the back on the left, it would be helpful. They'll just be safer during the week, and we're going to set them out in a different way next week.
please join me in the benediction. Now, let us go in peace to live a faith that matters, to grow in the love of God, and to serve wherever we are.